In the next 4 minutes, I'd like to introduce you to the experimental filmmaker Maya Duran. I was first introduced to Maya Duran in the 1990s, at the University of Colorado at Boulder Film School. I was taking an experimental film class taught by Stan Brakhage. The following was posted by Wendy Haslem on December 2002. Great Directors. Issue 23. Censusofcinema.com. Maya Duran, the High Priestess of Experimental Cinema, Meshes of the Afternoon. Maya Duran is recognizable as the woman with the enigmatic expression at the window, silently observing from within. Although her eyes indicate distrust, she is not desperate to escape her domestic space, but she is not entirely comfortable immured behind a glass. This image symbolizes some of Duran's most significant initiatives in experimental cinema. In this still shot, she establishes a silent connection with the eyes, suggesting the possibility for reverie or even hallucination. It foreshadows her experiments with superimposition and the juxtaposition of disparate spaces. It is an image that suggests the most compelling themes of her film work: dreaming, reflection, rhythm, vision, ritual, and identity. Like Cindy Sherman's film Stills, this image represents a poignant and hesitant moment, but unlike the photographs, Duran's still shot belongs within a dynamic, kinetic narrative. Whilst she is first recognized by this image, what is little known is that Duran was also a dancer, choreographer, poet, writer, and photographer. In the cinema, she was a director, writer, cinematographer, editor, performer, entrepreneur, and pioneer in experimental filmmaking in the United States. Like Jean-Luc Godard and Sergei Eisenstein, Maya Duran was both a film theorist and a filmmaker. Unlike these luminaries, Duran's writing remains relatively obscure in film theory, and her films are rarely screened outside of experimental or feminist film courses. The following is taken from Wikipedia. Maya Duran was a Ukrainian-born American experimental filmmaker and important promoter of the avant-garde in the 1940s and 1950s. Duran was also a choreographer, dancer, film theorist, poet, lecturer, writer, and photographer. The function of film, Duran believed, was to create an experience. She combined her expertise in dance and choreography, ethnography, the African spirit religion of Haitian Vodou, symbolist poetry, and Gestalt psychology, student of Kurt Kafka, in a series of perceptual, black and white short films. Using editing, multiple exposures, jump cutting, superimposition, slow motion, and other camera techniques to her advantage, Duran abandoned established notions of physical space and time, in carefully planned films with specific conceptual aims. Meshes of the Afternoon. 1943, her collaboration with Alexander Hamid, has been one of the most influential experimental films in American cinema history. She went on to make several films of her own, including Atlant, 1944, A Study in Choreography for Camera, 1945, and Ritual in Transfigured Time, 1946, writing, producing, directing, editing, and photographing them with help from only one other person, Hella Hayman, her camera woman.